Hey there folks, Luke here with the Outdoor Gear Review. I hope you're all doing well. Today for this episode, we are doing another fitness challenge, and this is the Sunday Funday Doorway Fitness Challenge. For the sake of this video, we'll make it nice and short, the title anyway, and we'll just call this the Doorway Challenge. But typically, I'll do something like this on a Saturday, Sunday, something like that. Usually a day when I'm just kind of taking it easy, just kicking it around the house here. I will kind of set a series of goals, a series of things that I need to do every single time that I go through a doorway. So let me go ahead and grab the camera, let me show you the equipment that I have here, give you guys an idea or some ideas of what you may use for this challenge. Here's my very used pull-up bar. We will definitely be using that. And then down here on the floor, we have some 30-pound weights, as you can see right there. And we have some push-up bars. And for this workout, that's pretty much all that we need. So to make this simple, we have the doorway, we have the pull-up bar, we have our weights, and we have our push-up stands. Now, the fun begins. Now, typically on a Sunday fun day, Saturday, whatever day I decide to do this, I'm kicking back, I'm just relaxing, and the purpose of this is basically to get a good workout over the period of a day. So there's really no time limit on this. You could do this for as long as you want to. You could make it as short as you want to. Typically, I will do this for at least a couple of hours, and that really allows me to get a pretty good workout in over time. So I may be here at the computer, might be messing around, doing who knows what, and every single time that I stand up and I walk through that doorway, I'm going to work out. I'm going to do a certain amount of reps for whatever move I want to do. And that also means every time I come through the door, I'm going to do more reps as well. So if I'm coming out of the bedroom, let's say to fill up my water bottle, that means that I'm going to do a workout. And so to start off, I'm going to do 12 pull-ups. And then every single time I might mix it up, I might do the same thing. It really is just whatever I feel like. So I'm going to start here. Okay, that's one. So I would fill up my water, and then when I go back through, I have to do another workout. You could see how over a course of a day, this can absolutely rip you up, get you nice and tired, be an awesome workout. Now, one thing that I like to do while doing this challenge is write down every single move that I do in categories. That way I can look back and I could say, whoa, I did 100 pull-ups or 200 push-ups or whatever. Typically, I just do those in categories: pull-ups, push-ups, weights, squats, and that's pretty good. You can incorporate abs into this if you want to throw down a mat on the ground. It's whatever you want to do. Now, so far, I've done 24 pull-ups. Now, since I came through the doorway, just so I could talk about the numbers and writing everything down, that means I have to do more working out. I will also have to go back through, which means more working out. So that's two times right there I know that I have to do something. So instead of doing pull-ups this time, I think I'm going to do some push-ups. Now, I should say that the name of this game is not to wear yourself out. This is a long time, overtime process. So don't go do 20 pull-ups all at once, wear yourself out, and then make yourself just useless for the rest of the day. You want to just pick a right in the middle number, because you are going to continue to do this over time. So don't wear yourself out, but still do enough to where you feel it, you get a good pump. Now, I'm going to do some push-ups because I did come through the doorway, but I'm going to go ahead and do some extra because I have to go back through it. So let's see here, what's a good number? Since I have to do it two times in a row, I'm gonna go for 20 push-ups each. So that'd be 40 push-ups for the out and then the back end. I'm just gonna do regular width push-ups here. Take your hands, put them together, and if you're using stands like I am, Even if you're not, you want your hands about that far apart. So you put your hands together where your elbows are. That's pretty much where you want your arms to be for that type of push-up. You can see very, very quickly how this is a good workout. And like I said, if you pace yourself and go all day long, woo, you will feel it tomorrow. All right, well, we're back in front of the camera again. We came through the doorway one more time, and that's because the mailman was knocking at the door, so he just cost me two more workouts. So what am I gonna do? We have 24 pull-ups already. We have 40 push-ups already. So let's go ahead and move to some lifting here, I suppose. Okay, we do have 30 pounds. I'll probably grab some more lighter weights for some sort of tricep workout. But, okay, let's do this. So we have our 30-pound weights right here. We're going to do some just very, very simple one-arm curls. And basically, we're just going to go up, hold it, and back down, and then on the other side. Let me go ahead and show you something real quick here. Now, when you're holding heavy weights like this, you want to make sure that you position your body in the right way. That way you're not putting too much strain on your back. So put one leg in front of the other. And that will help with stability for your back so you can pick up the weights and it's not too difficult, too hard, too stressing on your body. So let's go. Since we're doing 8, that actually means 16 if you're counting 1, 2, 3, 4. That'd be 8 per arm. Sit there. 8. Just breathe. I'm getting pretty hot and sweaty already. So when I checked the mail, I just did the weights for those. I did 16, I'm gonna write that down. But I have to do one more since I'm going back into the bedroom. I am gonna do some W pull-ups. And I'm gonna do 8 of those. They're pretty difficult, so watch this. You start at the side, down, up, down, up. You can see with W pull-ups, you're actually doing a bunch. You're doing a lot of pull-ups in just one move. Well, well, well. You guys caught me back in the kitchen again. I've gone through the doorway one more time. I did get a package from the mail dude, USPS, and I actually need a knife to open it up. So now we're back in here. We're doing another move. And honestly, this is a little bit faster pace than I intended, but that's the name of the game. That is part of the doorway challenge. Don't cheat, stick with it. You're gonna have a great workout. Now, since I have these 30-pound weights, I think I'm gonna do some calf raises. These are really, really simple, they're a lot of fun, and they will definitely build some muscle in your legs. Very, very good. Might as well get started with those. Now, when it comes to calf raises, there's 3 different types. You have your feet out and go up. You can have your feet straight and go up. And you can have your feet in and go up. We're just gonna start with a straight. We're gonna do 20. since we have to go back through the door, that means we have to do another move, and I think I'm going to work on triceps. That's that sweet little muscle there in the back. Now, if you have a back issue like I do, I don't lean over, I don't bend over all that much, so I just do it just a little bit, and I do the kickback. This is what this is here. So, that's eight right there. I'm pretty nice and tired. Like I said, the name of the game is not to wear yourself out, so take it slow, pick a number that you can achieve, and continue to do, because this is a long overtime process. We started this at 12 o'clock, and right now it is only 12:30. So, there you go. That's the game. I'm gonna write it down. Okay, well, we're back in here again. I had to use the bathroom, so it is time to do the kickbacks with my left arm, since we did it with our right arm the last time. So, we'll go ahead and do that now. I'm gonna, like I said, just slightly bend over because I do have a back issue. Some people really like to bend over and kick out. And I just can't do that, it bothers me. So I just do the best that I can. I suggest you do the same. When it comes to working out, there's no such thing as perfection. Some people will give you crap about form and all that stuff, and that's nonsense. As long as your form's pretty solid and not too crazy to the point where you're gonna hurt yourself, you're gonna be just fine. You're not perfect, I'm not perfect, the life isn't perfect, so you're not gonna be doing perfect moves. And that's just how it is. So we're gonna go ahead and do eight of these for my left arm. And of course, we're back into the bedroom, so we have to do another move. And I think I'm gonna go back to pull-ups this time. We'll do something here. Let's see, I have been doing 12 and 12. And I'm starting to get a little bit tired here, so we're gonna go to 10 this time. All right, my friends. Well, it's been about an hour since we started this, and we have all day to go. Or at least I'm gonna do this for 3 hours, because when you really break it down and consider it, you're not taking all that much time to really work out. It's just a few seconds here, a few seconds there. So you can definitely pull this out, stretch it out for a good part of your day. I needed some more water, so I'm back in the kitchen again. Yep, I came through the doorway. Now you guys know me, I like to drink a lot of water. I also like to drink a lot of coffee. But as far as beverages go, that's pretty much it. I do like tea every once in a while. But the key, my friends, the key to being healthy, to feeling good, is water. You have to drink water. Do not drink soda. That stuff is just pure crap. And if you're trying to lose weight, don't think diet soda is going to help you out, because that stuff's even worse. Soda, all in all, is just bad for you. So if you can stop drinking it, do so. You'll be happier you did. You'll feel better. But at the same time, I know everybody has vices. Some people smoke, some people drink soda, some people eat garbage fast food. Everybody has to deal with the repercussions of their decisions. Basically, what I'm doing here is just working on my triceps again, and we're gonna do some chair dips. Very easy. So 25 chair dips done, but we still have to go back through, so we have to do another move. I'm gonna grab another 15 pound weight. Okay, so this move here, it's very, very simple. We're gonna be working out the shoulders. And these are some of my favorite muscles right here. This definitely gives you, the men, that broad shoulder look. You got that nice lump of muscle there. It just looks good. So, very, very simple. This is what I call doubles. So basically you have your arms out with weights like this. So you start off with just one arm. One. Next one.
Two.
Both. That is also a core exercise. You're really going to have to strengthen your core. Take your breath, hold it, and then do it. And when you come down, go slow. Control that weight. I'm sure you're all thinking, isn't working out fun? And the truth is, folks, no, it's not always fun. It's a lot of hard work. It's not easy. And typically when things aren't easy, people don't want to do them. But you have to ask yourself, do you want to feel good? Do you want to look good? Do you want to do the things you want to do in life? Do you want to be able to spend time with your family, take your kids out walking, do things with loved ones? Only you can decide if it's worth it.
What is this?
Whoa! I can't show you what's on that table. I can't show you what that pack is right now. Whoa.
Stop trying to go there, cameraman. That's coming up soon.
Well, it's time for another move, and I think I'm gonna do some lawnmowers. Let me show you how to do those. Now, with lawnmowers, you could probably use the heaviest weight that you have because you're going to be using muscles that are very, very strong to begin with. All right, so here we go. Now, as you can see, I'm going to bend over. I'm going to have one leg going straight back, and I'm going to have one leg perfectly just about 90 degrees. So it's over and then down. You don't want to have your kneecap over your toes. You want to have a solid foundation. I'm going to start here and I'm going to have my left arm just resting on my leg. I'm going to take my right arm and I'm going to pick up the weight. And I'm just going to be starting the lawnmower. So the heavier the weight you go, the less reps you're going to have to do because it's going to be heavy. This is 52 pounds. Actually, it's 52.5 pounds, whatever. So we'll go ahead and get started. Start that lawnmower. Now, since I have to go back through the doorway, might as well do it on the other side to get it out of the way. Well, my friends, for this episode, for this fitness challenge, that's pretty much it. That is the Sunday Fun Day Doorway Challenge. And you don't have to do it on Sundays. You don't even have to do it on fun days. Just do it whenever you want to get yourself a good overall workout. It's not very strenuous. It's very easy going. You can really set your own pace. But I promise you, if you do this over the course of one day, you will be absolutely whooped. You'll be impressed with the results. In 3 weeks' time, no doubt about it. Now, so far, I've been doing this for about 2 hours, and I'm gonna just keep it going. Every time I walk through the doorway, I'm gonna work out, and when I go back in, I'm gonna work out. Do a different move each time. You could do a full overall body workout, and a really good one, if that's what you wanna do, or you could really focus on one body part and really blast it. Again, it's up to you. So, that's my Sunday Fun Day doorway workout. I wanna see yours. To those individuals who like to record videos, post them on Facebook, on YouTube, Show me your Sunday Funday workout. I'd love to see it. You can tell me, you don't have to do all the moves. You don't have to do the whole day. You can just show me some of your favorite moves. That's good enough. So guys, make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe. I will definitely see you all around. Strength and honor. Be well.